More grace to you, everybody. My name is Miss Joy Esosa Ogiriaki. My brother, he's an army officer in Jos. Some weeks ago, they called us and said, your brother gets accident. He did for Jos Fishing Hospital. I beg, your country, I can't see him. It don't reach 3 days now. We don't know who gets the person. He did unconscious, enough he talk. So we pick this phone and this SIM card for side of the road. So we now sent one of my brother to Jos. So when he got to Jos, he now met my brother. The doctor now said he has broken his waist, that he cannot use his waist. They now have to wear him a lumbar corset, and his legs are broken. So when my brother was leaving Benin, I had that faith that with God, all things are possible. I got the anointed materials from the church and sent it to my brother in Jos. So when my brother got to Jos, I now explained to him how he's going to use those anointed materials with faith. So my brother now wore the wristband on his hand, used the anointed sticker to put on his head, and used the other materials, the anointed water. He will drop it into a big ragolis container and start drinking it. That's what he takes in the morning, afternoon, and evening if he wants to take his drugs. That's what he uses. So the doctor now booked him for an operation, a major operation on his waist. As the doctor, after 2 weeks, the doctor now came to him and said, Ima, you have to undergo an operation on your waist to enable you to sit and to walk again in life. If not, you are going to remain there like that. So, and my brother now called me and told me this is the situation on ground. And I told him that we have a God that never fails. And I told him to continue using those anointed materials. Put the sticker on your waist. Wear your anointed wristband. Take your anointed water. You'll be very fine. So after the 2 weeks, they now took him to the theater. After taking him to the theater, they lose everything. They lose the bandage and they remove the lumbar concert. And the doctor checked. The only word the doctor said, he said there's no need for an operation. That's my brother on the screen. In cases like this, doctor says he cannot be able to sit for more than a year. But look at him today. He's sitting down and he's happy. When I called them, he told me that he cannot even believe what is happening to him. That the whole thing is just happening like a dream. That he can see that even right now, he feels like walking. And I said, don't worry, you will walk. It's very easy. So that's the testimony of my brother. You can see the anointed wristband on his hand. And the anointed sticker is on his waist. That's what he's using. That's what has been keeping him. So I thank God for his life. More grace to you, everybody. My name is Miss Joy Esosa Ogiriaki. The man standing next to me is my elder brother, Emmanuel Ehiwo. My testimony goes like this. God has been very faithful to me and my household, I must confess. Since the very first day I stepped my leg into this church, my life has been a blessing in so many ways. In my life, my marriage, my mother's children's life, it has been a blessing. So right now, I want my brother to testify what God has done for him.
Let's now hear from the brother to know what God really did in his life since he was admitted in the hospital.
More grace, everybody. My name is Brother Emmanuel Ewo. I'm an army officer serving in Jos. Around October last year, I was just sitting down. I was posted to Special Task Force in Jos. So in my duty location, I just sat down. I was having enough credit in my phone. So I don't know what actually happened. That evening, it was around 3:30 to 4. So the thing just dawned on me that I should go and recharge my phone because anything can happen in the night. I really want to make any phone calls. So I took my bike. I started the bike. I just took permission from my boss. That boss, please let me just get a recharge card. Not too far from my location. So he said, okay, no problem. And I left. What I could remember was that I bought the recharge card because I was in a haste to go back. Because he was telling me that I wanted to go out that evening. So I said, okay, let me just rush and come back. So I bought the card. I just folded it and put it in my wallet and started the bike again. That was all I could remember. After 3 days, it's as if I was in a dream. So I was hearing people saying in Jesus' name, they were praying. I said, where are they? What is happening? So when I opened my eye, I discovered I was in the hospital with bandage everywhere. I saw the environment. I saw nurses. I said, what happened? They said, for 3 days now, I've been in the hospital. I saw myself with oxygen, everything. I said, what happened? They said, a tipper failed brake. I was on a bike, and the tipper crushed me. That it was under the tipper they brought me out. That's how they brought me to the hospital. When they took me from under the tipper, they thought maybe I was dead. It was all they took me to the hospital, and they started doing some medical things like that. They discovered that there was still breath in me. So they had to put me on oxygen. They said they discovered my phone. So they took the SIM card, inserted it. I was calling everybody. So before I knew, my brother came with one wristband. I don't know where the wristband came from. He said it was my sister, Joy. This is the wristband. That Joy said I should wear this wristband with faith. That nothing is going to happen to me. I'm not going to die. Where is this coming from? So Joy called that by faith I should wear it. She brought some things from me. Some anointing water and some stickers, and she told me how I would be using it. It was my brother who was using them for me. So I was there in the hospital so many times. The doctor would come, they'll book me for operation. The first time they booked me for operation, I was to go to the lab. They said, no, let's wait till the other week. The other week, when they came, the doctor looked everything. They should take me for x-ray. They took me for x-ray. I came back. They said there would be no need for the operation. I said, what's happening? So like play. The healing was rapid because this is a situation where they've concluded that I will not be able to walk again. I will not be able to sit down, let alone I will stand with my both legs again. Even in my office, they're just waiting for them in the hospital to send a report to them so that they will book me on medically unfit and retrench me from my job. I said, God, too, this work, if it's you that has given it to me, and since I started this job, I've never committed any offense. Anywhere I go to, I used to find favor with people because they used to say, which kind of army officer is this? Because most of the times in the operation we are, they used to put us with police. And sometimes I see some police, the way they do their things, anything that happens because I must object, because it's just as if I'm fighting for the less privileged. So I said, God, if it is you that has given me this job, so that's what will be done. Most of the time they said, I cannot use wheelchair, I cannot use crutches, I cannot use this four-legged thing that should just remain in the position. I was in the hospital for about 3 months. So after the 3 months, they started removing some of the things that they placed in me. So they said, okay, for now, if at all I'll be able to go out, they should go and try to get wheelchair, buy me a wheelchair. I said, does that mean I'm crippled for life? The doctor said, no, with my condition. And those physiotherapy, if they come, if they see my condition, if they take the x-ray and check it, they will say, no, this situation, it has never happened like this. They've never seen a type like this. So to me, where this healing was coming from, even there was a day a doctor came and told me that, look, officer, if now God you deserve, hold on with your hand, the God is strong, well. Because this is your situation, we never ever see this type. Since how many years we've done it for this hospital, we never see this kind of situation. Because even in the place where the accident happened, the people in that environment, some of them, because of curiosity, they said in that axis it has never happened. Because they used to have accidents in that place, but there's never an accident. You say, okay, maybe those tippers crush somebody and the person will still save. That they've never heard it. So some people, even on their own, pay transport from inside the town. They'll come to the hospital just to confirm that, yes, I'm still alive. Because sometimes some people, I don't know them, they'll just go to my boss. My boss will call me. I will greet. How are you doing? I'll say, how is your health? I'll say, I'm better. You see, you will tell them. Some even talk to me on phone that they just want to confirm because they believe that day I died on the spot because I was bleeding everywhere, nose, mouth, vomiting blood everywhere. So just feel I was gone. Even in my waist, they felt no way. The waist, almost six places were broken. This joint that holds the both side, the whole thing was condemned. They said, no, let this boy just, let him be managing. When they discharged me from the hospital, they were forced to discharge me because they saw the way, they knew that it wasn't them that was treating me. It was not the treatment that was healing me. There was something that was healing me that even they cannot explain. The doctor said, we have no choice than to discharge you so that you can go for maybe any other medication. I said, okay, no wahala. They came, they discharged me. I left to my unit. When I got to my unit, everybody were coming. My RSN came that in his village, that he should take me to his village because I was on crutches. Everybody were bringing different places that we should go for traditional. Because I said, no, me, I want to go for traditional. I want to go and use traditional to cure myself because they said this hospital can no longer do it. But left to me alone, I felt I want to go and see that place where this thing came from. Who is that Pastor Israel that I have never seen? I want to go and see him. All I was saying was, if by the grace of God, I'll be able to set my eyes on this man, I don't need to go anywhere again. Because as I was coming with faith, I was on crutches. When I got to Lokoja, I dropped to my sister's place. When I got there, she started showing me things, telling me about this same Pastor Israel, that Joy has been telling her so many things, that this man is a strong man of God. So she saw this thing. How did you get this thing? I said, Joy sent it to me, and some anointing water and stickers. That's what I've been using to pray, and it has been a testimony to me. I don't know. That's why I said, I want to come and see where this wristband came from. Who anointed it? How strong is this wristband? When I got to Lokoja, I just told my sister. I was watching some testimonies about the church. She said, I can still listen to Emmanuel TV. She said, I should drop those crutches. One day they were praying. He said, I should hold the part of my waist that is worrying me, the part where I'm feeling the pain. I should pray in connection with TB Joshua. I told you to the glory of God. I prayed by faith. That very day, I dropped the crutches. I stood up. I started walking. Like play. I started walking inside the room. She said, you see, God is doing it. Like play. I left all the way from Lokoja with no crutches. I came to Benin. My mother saw me. Everybody was with the attention that if they see me, maybe they'll see somebody that is maybe deformed or maybe bent. When my mother saw me, she started crying. She knelt to the ground. My sisters, they were praising God. They were praising God. I said, no, this is not the time to do even. I want to go and testify, even though this will be the only time I'll have to testify to the goodness of God. That's my own testimony now. It's like an advice to everybody, to every Christian, to every believer in this church. Please. Even though it's a mistake you have done to come here, live with that mistake all the rest of your life. This is the place to be. This is the place to be. I can testify. If at all, I pray everybody in my unit there in just now is watching this TV, they will be very surprised. Because they are waiting for me now to go and come back and they declare me medically unfit. Because my legs, my waist, everything is gone. But to the glory of God, see now, I can walk. I can walk. I can walk.
Amen. Are you just sitting and looking like that? Lift your hands and shout hallelujah! Oh.
Through the internet, or maybe those that will have the opportunity to listen to this tape or watch this video. The God that is here is the living God. The God that heareth the cry of the people. The God that heareth the cry of the oppressed. No matter your situation, no matter your predicament in life, I beg you, hold on to this God. Believe and trust in every thing they give you here. Maybe the band, the stickers, the waters, everything, it has a divine connection. If for me that have never come here for once, I've never seen him, but only having the faith anywhere I am, as far as just a prayer that has been prayed here will affect me in just have that belief that if you come to this mountain and pray, it is done. Have faith, everybody.
Hallelujah.